Hydrophobic interaction of the nonpolar group present on site on the amino acid residue of a polypeptide backbone. So finally, we had studied up to that two different biomolecules, carbohydrate and protein. In carbohydrate, there is a glycosidic bonds play a major role, a type of covalent bond. And another was hydrogen bonding. These two types of bonding was playing a major role during the carbohydrate formation. And in the protein, we had studied four different types of bond. Now, the third biomolecules, friends, here is lipid. Lipid are biological molecules that are insoluble in water but are soluble in nonpolar solvent. So fatty acids may be saturated or unsaturated. If a fatty acid is saturated, possibly of bonding is the with the hydrogen atom, such that there exist no C double bond C bonds. Unsaturated fatty acid contains C double bond C bonds. So monounsaturated fatty acid have one carbon-carbon double bond, and polyunsaturated fatty acid have more than one carbon-carbon bond. If fatty acids are unsaturated, their shape is altered. From a saturated molecule, so the molecule in the lipid push apart, thus making more fluid and oily. So in one line, you can say there are two different types of fatty acid, unsaturated fatty acid and saturated fatty acid. We will discuss one by one the bonding. The first one, you can observe here, carbon-carbon single bond present in the saturated fatty acid. While in unsaturated fatty acid, carbon one carbon-carbon double bond is present. We want to discuss about the bonding present inside the lipid. So in the first, you can observe the saturated fatty acid where carbon-carbon single bond is present. There is no such double bond is present. While in unsaturated fatty acid, where one carbon-carbon double bond is present. The second, unsaturated fatty acid. In unsaturated fatty acid, you can observe in the figure that more than one carbon-carbon double bond is present, which will answer your that why lipid is unsaturated. So the three different structures, saturated, unsaturated, with one carbon-carbon double bond, and unsaturated with more than one carbon-carbon double bond. Now, since a double bond is stronger than a single bond, and the length of carbon-carbon double bond is shorter than that of a single bond. For containing a double bond is a liquid, and saturated fats are solid at room temperature, because the double bonds would inhibit the movement, and the resulting substance would be less like olive oil and more like butter. So finally, the lipids are classified as simple lipid and complex lipid, compound lipid. They are simple lipid, that is, they are esters of fatty acid. They are subclassified as fat and waxes. Fat, they are ester of fatty acid and glycerol, and waxes, they are ester of long chain fatty acid and long chain alcohol. Compound lipid, they are esters of fatty acid containing the additional to alcohol and fatty acid, other groups also. Further subclassified, this compound lipid further subclassified under phospholipid, glycolipid and lipolipid. That is the first one, that is phospholipid. They contain fatty acid, glycerol, nitrogenous bases, phosphoric acid and other substituents. The second one is glycolipid. Glycolipid are fatty acid with carbohydrate and nitrogen but without phosphoric acid. And lipoproteins, they are the protein lipid complexes. If you observe here the structure, this is not much more readable, but you can understand slowly when I will discuss about the types of different lipids, and they are having different types of bonds present inside that. Derived lipid, they are derived by hydrolysis from the compound and simple lipid. Most common derived lipids are steroids, terpenoids or terpenes, and carotenoids. Steroids, they do not contain fatty acid. They do not contain fatty acid. You can observe here. They are non-saponificable, and not hydrolyzed on heating. Terpenes or terpenoids, among the non-saponification or the lipid which cannot be saponificated found in the plants, are many hydrocarbons known as terpenes. And the third one is carotenoid. carotenoids or terpenes with 40 carbon atoms. They are called terpenoids or tetraterpenes having more than one carbon atom, that is more than 40 carbon atoms, includes carbon called carotenoids. You can observe the structure of lipid here, the example of steroid, example of terpenes, and example of carotenoid. Then three different structure, you can observe the double bond present, you can observe the hydrogen bond present, and finally we will discuss about the triglyceride, or the lipid consisting of glycerol molecule bonded with three fatty acid molecules. And the bond present inside the lipid is the bond between the molecule are covalent and are called ester bond. So finally, we were trying to discuss about the types of bond present inside the lipid are ester bond. They are formed during the condensation reaction and more common in bacteria and eukaryote. So this is the structure of the ester bond, that is R-C-O-O-R. C, you can observe here that the CH2OH and CH2OH, this is a molecule reacts with the another molecules and make ester bond between, that is R-C-O-O-R, a ester bond format, and this will lengthening and make a huge chain of terpenoids and steroids where the ester bond presents. How ester bond present inside the bacteria, archaea and eukaryotes, all three. Ester bond linkage in which one or more of the carbon atom on glycerol is bonded to alkyl chain. These types of bond occurs in archaea, mostly in archaea, that is called linkage in which more than one type, more or one carbon atom on glycerol is bonded to alkyl chain, and this type of bond occurs in bacteria as well as archaea and as also in the eukaryotes. So in lipid, major bond present playing a role, that is called ester bond. Now the fourth biomolecule, that is called nucleic acid. Nucleic acid are the polynucleotides having high molecular weight. The monomeric unit, which is nucleotides, can be either DNA or RNA. They are vehicle of genetic inheritance. So if we study the structure of nitrogen, structure of DNA or a structure of RNA, you can find different types of bond present. The very important bond is hydrogen bond between the adenine, between the two nitrogen bases, and the very important, that is called important bond, phosphodiester bond present here. There are four organic bases generally in the DNA formation, that is adenine and guanine, both purine containing two rings in their structure, and thymine and cytosine, both pyrimidine containing only one ring in their structure. In RNA, four bases are same except the thymine, which is replaced by the uracil, a pyrimidine basis. Next, that is the basic structure of nucleotide. I'm using the paper to draw the structure of the basic structure of the nucleotide. This is a pentose sugar. If you study, this is a pentose sugar. This is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, and here is carbon number 5th, CH2OH group is attached. This is a pentose sugar actually, and pentose sugar, I will discuss that in pentose sugar, in DNA, this pentose sugar is called deoxyribose sugar, deoxyribose in DNA. Why it is deoxy? Because from the second number of carbon, there is a loss of oxygen. One oxygen is lost from the second carbon group, and that's why this is called deoxy. And from second carbon group, the oxygen is lost. That's why it is in chemical form, it is called 2' deoxy. You can observe here 2' deoxyribose. Actually, the full form of DNA is not deoxyribose nucleic acid. It should be 2' deoxyribose nucleic acid, because here we were mentioning the number of carbon from where the oxygen is lost. That's why it becomes deoxy instead of ribose. And this is the structure OH, H. This is called OH, this is H, and this is OHH. This is the structure of ribose sugar, that is pentose sugar present inside the DNA. Now, how it makes a nucleotide? We are discussing about a nucleotide structure, how it becomes nucleotide. That at the first carbon, from the first carbon, a nitrogenous base is coming to bind. A nitrogenous base, N2 base. This N2 base may be adenine. This N2 base may be guanine. This N2 base may be cytosine, thymidine. Anyone nitrogenous base is coming to bind at the first carbon of the pentose sugar. And at the fifth carbon, this is the fifth carbon. At the fifth carbon, here the phosphoric acid P group is coming to bind. O minus, O minus, OH. Suppose we are talking about a single phosphate. So at the fifth carbon, the phosphoric acid is coming to bind of the sugar, and at the first carbon, any N2 base, adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine is coming to bind, and from the second carbon, oxygen is replaced. I'm talking about DNA nucleotide. So suppose I am making another, totally, when they react, they make like this. Suppose we are talking about adenosine. So adenine is coming to bind at the first carbon, and CH2OP double bond O, O minus, OH. At the fifth carbon, phosphoric acid is bound now. And now the adenine is coming to bind. Adenine is example of a nitrogenous base, is coming to bind at the first carbon. And here is H, oxygen is removed. So this nucleotide will be adenosine monophosphate. That means adenosine monophosphate, AMP. How it forms? By binding of a sugar. The major role is the central core is the sugar, pentose sugar, where at the first carbon nitrogenous base is binding, at the second carbon oxygen is removed, and at the fifth carbon phosphoric acid is bound. So now this is a nucleotide. Every nucleotide you can practice at your home by changing this nitrogenous base by cytosine, guanine, thymidine, and by increasing the phosphoric acid. Suppose we are talking about ATP, just add two more phosphoric acid, it will become ATP, triphosphate, adenosine triphosphoric acid, triphosphate. So it becomes a nucleotide triphosphate. Now it is a monophosphate, it is a nucleotides. Now what types of bond are present? Here double bond is a covalent bond. Here is a hydrogen bond between, or covalent bond between the nitrogenous base and the sugar, that is first carbon of sugar. Now after a few times I will again use this paper to discuss about the bonding. Now come to the slide, that is PPT, bonds in nucleotides. Here we had the basic structure of nucleotide is written, I had discussed on paper, that is phosphate, pentose, sugar and base. Nucleotides can link together by the formation of phosphate ester bond. How this bond form I will discuss later on, just after 2 minutes. The hydroxyl group of a phosphate on one nucleotide undergo condensation reaction, underline condensation reaction, with the hydroxyl group on the carbohydrate ring of another nucleotides. The process may continue building of nucleic acid molecule. These are polymer and are called polynucleotide. As I told you that the structure of nucleotides, one by one, more than one nucleotides joined together with the help of phosphodiester bond, and they will form a polynucleotide, which we will discuss in the structure of DNA. DNA is formed from two polynucleotide chain. Each chain has a helical structure. The two helix are then intertwined to give a double helix. The base are on the inside of the helix, and the phosphate group and on the outside. The two helices are held together by pairing of the nucleotide base through hydrogen bonding. because the double ring purine are bigger than the single ring pyrimidine, the structure can only form with purine base opposite pyrimidine bases. Hydrogen bond, I will discuss how the bondings are in polynucleotide chain. Just now come to the paper. I'm talking about the structure of a polynucleotide. Suppose this is a nucleotide, as we have studied. This is a nucleotide. This is a nucleotide having adenine. This is first carbon, this is second carbon, this is third carbon, this is fourth carbon, and CH2 O P double bond O, OH and O minus. This is fifth carbon. Before going to the what types of bond, why we are talking about 5 prime to 3 prime structure, I am just telling you. 5 prime is here, the phosphate group can bind, another phosphate group can bind, or another nucleotide come to bind from the upper side. That's why this is called 5 prime end. And similarly, the phosphate bond form between the 5 prime and 3 prime. That's why this is called 3 prime sugar. The major role is sugar. Every carbon is involved. First carbon is involved in the formation of binding with the nitrogenous base. Second carbon in the DNA involve the removal of oxygen. Third carbon involved in the formation of phosphodiester bond by binding to the another nucleotide. I will show you. And the fifth carbon is helping binding with the third carbon with another nucleotide, as well as for the binding of the phosphate group. So except fourth carbon here in the formation of polynucleotide, each and every carbons of the sugar or the core sugar, pentose sugar, is involved in the formation of the DNA structure. So just so the bonding, I'm drawing another pentose sugar. This is another deoxyribose sugar, where suppose here is the guanine is attached as a first carbon, third carbon, this is fourth carbon, and CH2OH, suppose O double bond, this is double bond O, OH and O minus. How they are making 5 prime to 3 prime and how they are making phosphodiester bond? Here is H, here is OH, here is H, H, and here is OH on the first carbon. So this fifth carbon, this phosphoric acid reacts, this phosphoric acid from here OH